In this video, we're going to provide an overview of the optimized room tag placement Dynamo graph for use in generative design. So we're going to take a look at a few of the sections of the graph available, what they do, and some of the logic involved to make it work. So to get started, we will open up the generative design panel and click on Create Study. The sample files for this workflow are available on the generative primer, which is linked in the blog post as well. So let's go ahead and take a look at this graph. We'll select the edit icon on the create study window, and this will open up Dynamo with its UI so we can take a look at all the different sections of this Dynamo graph. With this Dynamo graph open, we'll go ahead and minimize this create study dialog. We will see we have a few inputs available to us. First, we have an option input. This is what enables generative design to iterate through several different solutions for us. In this case, this Dynamo graph is using a package called DynaShape to create the optimization. So all we're going to use generative design for is randomization to create several different options. Our next input is the select rooms input. This is a modified select model elements by category node with rooms as the category. By default, on the advanced sample model, we have a few elements pre-selected. The last input that we need is to select a room tag to use. So this gives us the room tag that we want to place within our model. So what we need to do is we'll go ahead and place a room tag off to the side, and that'll be the room tag that we use. So in order to fulfill that input, I'll just go ahead and click select and select that room tag right now. With that room tag selected, our selection is going to be updated, and we'll go ahead and press run. With that run complete, we can now take a look at the rest of the Dynamo graph to see what it's doing. But first, let's go over a little bit of background as to why we would even want to tag rooms with generative design. So in Revit, we have an option under the annotate tab to do tag all. Tag all is really great to get you started, but as you can see, if we use it for room tags, it kind of just places the tags everywhere for us. In this case of cafeteria, it's placed over tables. We have tags that interact with other modeled objects, with other tags, dimensions, door swings, and so on. So that's not exactly a perfect scenario for us in our case. We'd like to optimize this a little bit. So we'll go ahead and undo that tag all, and then we'll navigate back to the Dynamo graph. So in Dynamo, if I navigate the background 3D preview, we'll see that we have a few things going on in here. First, we have the room outlines of the selected rooms available to us. These outlines are represented as black lines. Within the room outlines, we also have the bounding objects. These are represented by pink lines. These include modeled elements, dimensions, tags, and other clashing elements within rooms. We can always add to that collection as well. That portion is completed on this room object lookup section of the Dynamo graph. So we get those elements, get their bounding boxes, and pull those from the rooms. This purple section is caching the data for us, so it's remembering all of the different room elements for generative design, which is a requirement for generative design. As we scroll down the graph, we have a portion highlighted in green. All of these nodes are from the package DynaShape. These nodes do things such as collision detection and other operations to rubber band the room tag as close to the center of the room as it can. So with DynaShape, we'll include a link in the blog post, DynaShape allows you to simulate physics in Dynamo. So this includes simulations like form finding or gravity simulation or anything like that. In our case, we're using it to maintain a distance to the center of the room. Typically, when tagging rooms, we want to tag the room as close to the center as we can. So that's what DynaShape is doing for us. In a recent update, Long, the creator of DynaShape, added an option for us to be able to add collisions to it, which once again are represented by the pink lines in the rooms. I want to point out that DynaShape does do the optimization for us, and that is all right here in the solver.executeSilently node. After we've created an iteration, so let's go ahead and slide this randomization slider, this option, and hit run real quick. As we create layout options, we will see them update, and we see red and green squares as well. Those clashes are being analyzed in a package called VASA. This package allows us to analyze models as voxels, which are 3D point elements, if you will, and we're seeing how much overlap there is and giving it a score. This is really important for generative design because we need to know how to score these designs. That way you can iterate through them and see which one's most pleasing in all these different ways. So that's with the package VASA. It's a really great package. It has a lot of other nodes for pathfinding and things like that. So we'll be sure to link a video down below for the overview of VASA. The last section that actually makes changes in Revit is the Create and Update Room Tag section. This uses a custom node from a package called Rhythm, and what it does is it will actually tag rooms or update the room tag based on your inputs. In our case, we are inputting our current view, the rooms to tag, the location that we optimized, the tag type that we selected, and we're going to try to update existing room tags if there were some already placed. Keep in mind, sometimes it can't find room tags that are already placed if they're outside of the room or other things happen within Dynamo, but it does its best to try to correct that and find room tags that exist. So with that overview complete, we'll go ahead and click Save. We'll close Dynamo and we'll navigate back to Create Study. So back in Create Study, we will select the optimized room tag placement. By default, the workflow is saved as randomized. That's accessible in these three dots on the upper part of the screen, and you click Save Default Settings. Since we did select a room tag in Dynamo and save it, that's pre-selected as well. So what we can now do is go ahead and click on Generate, and Generative Design will start iterating through and creating a whole bunch of different solutions for us to choose from. Let's go ahead and let this generate and we'll take a look. Alright, so Generative Design is done running. It ran rather quickly this time because we had 10 generations set. You can increase that number significantly if you'd like. For the purpose of this example, we left it fairly low. So now as you click on thumbnails, and we can go ahead and make this a little bit bigger, collapse our studies, you will start to see that we have results available. So this first result's pretty good. The cafeteria tag's fairly close to the middle. This next one's a little bit closer. The other ones are within their space completely. They're colored green to indicate that. And we can go through and start to see which one we find the best option for us. In the case of generative design, we are able to highlight the options in the bottom on the parallel coordinates chart. So in our case, let's filter this down to the ones that are the closest to the centers of the rooms. And for this case, I think this one's probably our best option. So with that complete, we can go ahead and click on Create Revit Elements, and Generative Design will go through and tag all these rooms in the current view for us. Keep in mind, for Generative Design, to create changes to the Revit model, you need to implement gate nodes. We covered that in a previous blog post, so that one we'll link as well. Alright, so with the elements created, we will see that this cafeteria tag has a little bit of overlap with a table. That's okay, that's acceptable. All of these other ones are pretty good because they didn't have anything clashing as well. So with that complete, that's how the workflow works. If you want to use this on another floor, you would activate that floor level view, and then you can refresh your selections and create a new study. In my case, I'll go ahead and click Undo in Revit, and we'll make this a little more complicated by adding some additional wall tags, and we'll go to Create Study to create a new study with this new option available to us. Keep in mind, this might not be an exact use case that you might have, but we're just going to make it a little bit harder for the solver to figure out. So within the Define Study dialog, we can see that we still have the same room selected and the existing room tag selected. Let's go ahead and update our room selection. We'll focus on these rooms right here, and we'll click Finish. With those selections complete, let's go ahead and click on Generate. Once again, Generative Design will go through, create all these options for us to preview before making changes in Revit. All right, so now you can see that we made it a little bit more difficult for the solver. We added those wall tags that made it have a little bit more clashing happen. So as you can see, we can start to filter this down considerably more than the last example. In this case, this one looks pretty good. This one, I would say this one probably looks the best. So we'll filter this down to ones that are closest to the room center, and we'll go from there. In this case, I think this one works the best. So what we'll go ahead and do is click on Create Revit Elements. All right, so with that complete, we do have our room tags placed. We'll notice that this prep slash dish room did avoid that wall tag pretty well. This conference room, we can shift that over just a little bit, and that's pretty good as well. And the cafeteria is the one that we picked from the first iteration. If I were to create more iterations, we would get significantly better results. I only did 10 iterations, but you can kind of see how this starts to work. All right, so with that in mind, this Dynamo graph is one that you can use to create room tags. It demonstrates how to use 3D packages to do 2D things. So room tags are something that a lot of times we won't think generative design can help with, but similar to the viewport example, we can start to use some of these packages available to us to simulate how we would tag rooms, for instance. In this case, we used DynaShape to stick the room tag as close to the center as we can. We used VASA to iterate through and see the overlap, and then we used another open source freely available package to tag the rooms, because tagging rooms isn't something we're able to do in out-of-the-box Dynamo. So I encourage you to download the sample files, dissect it a bit, it's very noted, and just try it out and see what you can come up with using it.